So it's, sorry, your name?
Bessie.
Bessie?
What is this for? Is
Bessie it, Holland.
It's Russian information,
isn't
it? Bessie Pretty John.
Okay. Sorry, your name is?
My name is Brian Rivers.
So tell us about being a Dartmouthian and what it means to you for the fountain to be open tonight.
Well, to me, my father, although he was in the old war, he was a fisherman, a local fisherman. And I remember during the war, I was the little girl who used to go up on the rocks when the boats used to get blown out outside. And I was the little girl who used to climb up on the rocks and I used to bring down the food and the tins of dried apple,
seaweed.
And we used to share it with all the people along the seafront. Everything in Dartmouth was shared. The clothes were passed on, and we had a precious upbringing, even though it was through the war and through a very, very hard time. But the people that we were brought up were very, very precious. They really were. And I am so proud to live in Dartmouth all my life. I am really proud. And I think that some of the salts of the earth came from our lovely town. And during the war, when we had the American servicemen here, they were lovely, and we could learn an awful lot from them, but they could have learned an awful lot from us. And I really, really think the gentleman upstairs was smiling on us to keep our lovely town and our lovely place just as it is.
I was born in Dartmouth on the 2nd of April 1926. That's a long time ago. So I can remember the war.
Really?
And where we're stewed now, 1944, where we stood now, you'd have had all these Sherman tanks. That was the only road, the main road into Dartmouth was down there. Mm. And all the Sherman tanks was coming here and going on to the landing craft. Mm. And I was 16 then. So I know Dartmouth very well. And I still live here and I'm very grateful. I'm one of the family of the people who used to run the pleasure ships on the river, the Red Cruisers, you know.
Because
That's my brother there, over there.
Yeah.
And our father was a pilot. A Trinity House pilot.
Yeah.
They're not in existence now. They used to bring all the ships in. Ships coming in for coal and timber and that sort of thing. So, and I used to play water polo in the boat float, which is behind you, before the war and just after the war.
Much space to play water polo there now.
Well, they say this health and safety is a load of rubbish. The boat float is cleaner now.
My mother used to say to me, and this is in the 30s, and I'm 86, my brother there's 74. There was a brother in the middle of us. You remember my brother Dennis who died? And my mum used to say to us, this is regatta time, the end of August, when it was all, you know, hundreds of people. See you at the fountain at 6 o'clock and don't be late.
Fountain is a base where we used to meet. If the regatta was here or anything was here, this fountain meant a lot to us. Yeah, the local old boys used to gather around, and the old coal lumpers, my father was a fisherman, but they were also coal lumpers, had two jobs, and they used to walk up and down here in a line, and they used to turn together, nobody said anything, and they turned back. And the wonderful people that we've got in Dartmouth are the salts of the earth. I'm so proud to be a Dartmouthian and to come from these precious people.
Right.
And this is one of the loveliest cities, well, loveliest little towns with all the lovely, weren't it, Brian?
Yeah.
Everybody shared what they had. If we had any clothes that didn't fit, we'd pass it on. My father was a fisherman. And we had no money, but we used to take some fish up to Mrs. Horn. She hasn't got any money. And we used to share that. But then a stick of rhubarb would turn on the door or something else. It was just wonderful what we had. If the rest of the world had what we had here in Dartmouth during the war, they would be very lucky. And I feel so proud to be brought up in a beautiful town like Dartmouth. This fountain is always a part of it, wasn't it, Brian?
It was.
It really, really was.
I think.
And thank you for bringing it back as it is, sweetheart. because we're back where we started.
It is really that they come back and just not just tarmacked it over. Like during the war, the Americans came through here with their tanks and went on the land in barges. And I said to them when they were digging up, I said, no good digging up here. I said, the Americans, it's solid concrete. They said, oh no, Bess. I said, yes it is. I said, I saw them laying a path, because we used to have two slipways and two bridges going up there, and the Americans used to have their landing barges, and the tanks used to come through there going up the front. And after they started to dig, they said, blooming Bess, you're right, you know. It's solid concrete under here. I said, I told you so.
So they should have trusted you.
Yes, darling.
So I suppose I end this interview by saying, see you at the fountain at 6.
Well, 6, darling, it is now 20 to 7.